Good day, everybody. This is your host Ali Rathor from TechRat. In today's tutorial, we will learn how to add texture to your object in a couple of steps, and you can get free textures. So stick around. Welcome back. Now, to start off with, you'll have your Blender open and you'll have something similar to this one. So I'm going to press General. And before we start, I'm just going to press the N key and have my screencast key so you guys know which keys I'm pressing. So I'm going to press the numpad 1 key, press A and remove everything. Now, before we begin this tutorial, you need to check if you have the necessary add-ons, which are free. So go to Edit, then Preferences, select the add-on and check, type in Node. And check if you have all these three checked. So Node Wrangler, Preset, and Arrange. The version that I'm using is 3.2.1 for Blender. Now, to begin with, I'm going to press Shift A, get the mesh and get the plane. Press numpad key 1 just to see if my plane is there. I'm going to press S and make it a bit bigger, right? Next thing we need to do is press Tab to go into the edit mode, then press Control E and click the subdivide. Click the subdivide on the left bottom corner, and I'm going to make it 50. You can make it 100, depend on how many slices or vertex do you need. So I'm going to press 3 key to go into the faces mode, so you can see our mesh has been divided. Now, to get the texture, go to the website polyhaven.com. That's where you can get free texture. You have other websites as well. This is the one that we'll be using for our example. So click on the Browse Textures. You'll see a lot of textures, and we're going to go to the terrain one. This is the one that we're going to use. And click on the Aerial Rock. This is the example that we're going to use. It's by Rob Tutel. I hope I named him correctly. Shout out to him for providing us with a free texture. So all of you can click the download or any other texture that you can download. You'll get a zip file that you will unzip, and it'll have a Blender file and a texture file. So the texture file is the one that we need. All right, so coming back to Blender, I am going to click the object and then go to my shading tab. So click the shading tab and you'll come into this tab. I'm going to press Shift and the middle mouse key to make it a bit move it top, and Shift tab again. Now, the thing you need to do is attach a material to it. So I'm going to click New and you'll see Material 1. I'm just going to name it Ground Texture to get the texture that we want. And you can name it anything you want. So now, because we installed the add-ons, we had them checked, you'll have a screen like this. You can use your mouse scroll button to the middle button to zoom in. So you can click, if it's unselected, just select and click the left key, click to principal BSDF and press the shortcut keys Control Shift and the letter T for Tetris. Okay, once you'll press this one, you'll get an option and you can go to the section where you've installed or you've downloaded your texture. So you'll have a zip file. I've already unzipped this and double click that one. The folder, you'll have a Blender folder and a texture file. We need the texture one. Now, in my case, I have 4 files, but depending on your texture, you might have more or less. Select all of them and then click Principal Texture Setup. Now, the beautiful thing about Blender is that it's going to set up this texture by itself, so you don't need to go and do multiple settings. See, so you don't need to confuse yourself with anything. You might have more tables or less depending on the texture, but the one that we're going to manipulate is the displacement one. I hope you guys can see this one. We'll do it later, a bit later. Now, at the top, you can see our texture has been added into your plane. If you want to leave it to there, it's up to you. You can use this object, but if you're looking for a bit of texture with the displacements and you want to see the grooves in it or the height and different crevices and stuff like that, then you'll do the second option. Now, after this one, what you need to do is go to your layout again, and then at top Before going to the render mode, we need to add our light. So I'm going to press Shift A and add light. The one that I'm adding is called sun. Pressing G Z axis to increase it. On the right hand side, while I've got my light selected, I'm going to go and increase the strength of the light. Understood? Now you can't see texture here because we are not in the render mode. Now I'll go to the render one and you'll see our texture is plane or is flat on the plane. Now you can use this one if you wanted, just select it and export it as an FBX or an OBG. But for me, I need to have a bit of terrain that looks much more realistic or have crevices in it. So for that one, what you need to do is select the render properties. And by default, we're in the Eve engine, but we don't need the Eve engine. We need to go to cycles. Depending on your PC, I've got an RTX 3060 Ti, so I'll go and click GPU compute. Now for me, the maximum samples is 1024 because I have an RTX. For you, you can have it 150 or 300, as much detail you need. Now, once we've got the cycles and the GPU, select the object, go into the material properties of your object and scroll down. So you'll have the surface, scroll down, you can minimize this one. And then you'll have the displacement option. Again, if you have the Eve engine, you won't see this displacement option. For this to work, you need to have cycle. So we're not going to do anything with the displacement. We're just going to go click settings and then scroll down and you'll see an option called displacement with bump only. Now this is version Blender 3.2.1. If you're working on a previous version like 2.9, this option is separated. So you'll have to find out. I think it's very easy. It's under settings, but I think it's separately just given two options. Now for us, we'll need to use displacement only instead of bump only. Once you click that, you'll see your terrain has suddenly changed. Again, if you're in Eve, you won't see this. This has to be done in cycles. Now, if you're happy with this one, you can use this one. But for me, it's too deep and steep. So what I'll do is I'll go back to the shading area and click the render in the shading area to see my model, pressing shift and middle mouse. So I need to make it more flatter. The thing I'll do is I'll change the scale. So for me, the value that I like is 0.20. So that's the one which I like, where my player can move and I can use this in my game. So if you rotate it using your middle mouse key, you'll see the crevices has gone down. So if you're looking for something very subtle, you can keep changing it, or you can use like very minimum scaling. So this value depends on what you are looking for, right? So once this is done, your object is ready. You can go to your layout area and you can click it and export file, export as an FBX. Then you can place wherever you want the object to, select the object and export it. But I'm not doing this. So for me, if I want to render this one, I'm going to press one key and see which view I like. For that, I need to add a camera. I'm going to add a camera. So I don't need to set the camera like manually. What I'll do is I like this view. I'll set up in my layout view and I'll just go to the view option and I'll go to align view and align active camera to view. What this does is sets the camera to your view. I'm going to press the G and the middle mouse button to zoom out, then press G and I'm going to move my camera a bit. Again, press G, middle mouse button to zoom out, press G to set up. So this view, it's up to you what you guys want. Like for me, I can have it a bit like this. Set up again. And that's it. So once that's done, I can go and render the image. If I'm looking for an image, all I'll do is I'll go to render and render image. Right? Now, because we're using computer GPU and my sample size is 4096, that's a very high sample. You can have 500, 1000 or 300, depending on how much processing your computer can take. But this looks pretty realistic with the textures and you can see how our plane has actually moved out. And once this is done, you can just image and save image once the processing is done. And that'll give you your rendered image. Mine has been rendered, so I'll just save. And I can save it as a PNG. Closing that. And this is how you'll get your terrain texture in your plane. So you can do it in a sphere, you can do it in a square, or if you've made a model land, export it to use in your game, Unity, Unreal, Roblox, or anything you want. I hope the steps were pretty easy. They're not that difficult, and they're not that settings. It's basically 2-3 settings to do. And then you can change the lighting to spotlight or something like that. That's up to you. Again, the textures you can get from the website Polyhaven, you can use as many textures as you want. And I've gone through the tutorial step by step. If you have any questions, just put them in the comment. If you have, you want to look at any tutorial, if you're having issues, you can ask me, we'll reply. And I hope this helps you learn textures. Wait for another video where we'll describe what's the difference between material and texture. And for texture, you need to have material. You need to understand, for this one, we are not using this texture properties. We're just using materials and going into shading part. And that's how we use the terrain. Don't forget to subscribe the channel and like the video. And we are now on Patreon as well, so you can select any tier you want. The project files will be on the on all three tiers for Patreon. It'll help us support the channel and bring more tutorials regarding Blender, Unity program, Unity gaming, game designs, and programming for React and React JavaScript as well. So we have a lot of stuff that's coming in. We've got a podcast as well, and we do give different reviews to games and stuff. So anything related to technology, we are bringing to you. I hope this was an easy tutorial, not too long. And for those of you who need any questions or have any setup issues, just ping us for this one, and we'll be happy to help you. This is your host, Ali Ratwa. Take care, bye-bye, and keep safe.